Wasn't it, honey? She was north of
yes,
Key Road.
Yes, she's born. Well, Mom, hey, Mark.
Hi, Kurt. Yeah. How are you doing?
Yeah, doing fine. This is,
yeah, but he's Mark bigger than our
he's changed.
Isabella.
And Isabella.
Hi, nice to meet you.
God, and Isabella.
Again?
Yes, sir.
Yep.
Yes, and I tell you, Evelyn was an art teacher.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. She was very, very talented in mm-hmm. art and in a lot of other things, yep. too.
Active in the church.
Oh, and, yes.
She had her master's and her doctorate.
Yes, she got her
art.
Doctorate.
I from ISU.
Wow.
And you know, she was visiting the Chamber of Commerce down in Ocala.
Yeah, they had moved to Florida when they retired.
When did they move down there?
In 93.
I couldn't remember.
I bet David's working today. He would have come. They're in heavy construction, mm-hmm. and they can only work when the weather's right. And they've had to work a couple of Sundays. This is the first year they've ever done that.
So is Harold still living?
Harold's still living here.
Okay.
Yeah. He's in Ocala.
Okay.
Still down there.
Okay. Yeah. I didn't realize this. So that's okay.
Yeah. I wish he could have been here. But it's a long trip.
I've tried to get him up here any number of ways or times.
No way, huh?
He can't move.
I thought maybe he would move back up here after Evelyn died, but I didn't know if.
We tried.
Well,
that's all you can do. So.
Yeah.
There are graves right over there. John is buried right there.
Uh-huh.
Howell Elgie was my dad, and he still was my mom.
I remember your mom.
Yeah, and the Kesslers, you wouldn't remember
no.
them at all, but they were my grandparents. And the Powell, some of the Powell grandparents are over across the drive.
Yeah.
All of our relations are very curious.
Okay, well I want to do a couple things here. I thought that it would be fitting, I should have had this bookmark. Should fall right open to it, but I wanted to read the 23rd Psalm. I thought that would be very fitting here. And I have a poem, and then we'll do a prayer. And I know you didn't want anything lengthy, but we do want to pay tribute to the mother. And I know that she heard that song this morning. I'm sure of that. That was very good. I'm sitting there thinking, and you expect me to preach after he sings those things like that? But that was good. Okay, so let's just take a minute here and reflect upon Evelyn, as we know that she's since passed away, and so she's in a happy place. You know, she was a true Christian, and so we know that God has provided for there. So from the 23rd Psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lay down in the green pastures. He leads me beside the quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And that's what she's doing. She's dwelling in the house of the Lord forever. And we're just so appreciative as we reflect upon some real good memories there. But a poem that I find very very enjoyable at this time, as we look at this and we stand here and we look at her headstone, and we see those that she was born on January the 14th in 1929 and passed away on January the 10th, 2013. And so typically when we write that date, and in fact we see here at Frank's there's a dash between there and many times in most of them you'll see dashes between them, and this poem is entitled The Dash. I read of a preacher who stood to speak at a funeral of his friend. He referred to the dates on his tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of his birth and spoke the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For the dash represents all the time that she spent here on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the cows, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard, or the things you would like to change. For you never know how much time is left. You could be in your dash mid-range. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way other people feel. To be less quick to anger, to show appreciation more, to love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. We treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this little dash might only last a little while. So when the eulogy is being read, with your life's action to rehash, would you be pleased with the things they say on how you spend your dash? So what matters is that little dash between your birth and your death, and it sounds to me like Evelyn spent it very well. But she was a very caring individual and one that was a helping hand to everyone, and it looks as though she lived a full life, and that we pray that not only for her here in a minute, but also for her husband, who's undoubtedly feeling probably lonely, you know, without having her in there. So let us pray. Lord, as we stand here this day in this beautiful sunshine, and you know, our hearts are heavy that we have lost a loved one, but as we remember the impact that she made upon others in the life that she was here on earth, we marvel and are glad that we are a part of it and was in the midst of all of that. We still miss having her around, but we know that she is with the Lord and the Lord's place that He's prepared a place for. We pray for her husband left behind that he also is, I'm sure, feeling alone after living for such a long time with her. So be with him in these days as well. And we ask that you would continue to be with the family as they go on about. It's hard to lose a loved one, but we can be at least satisfied to know that she is in a heavenly place. And so this day we just thank you for sending her our way, for her being a part of our lives, and that we are just so glad that she was with us. We ask now that you would take care of the family, not only in these days, but in future days, and that they could also just send that impact that Evelyn has started. And in all of these things, we'll give you all the praise for your power and your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
That's my pleasure. I'm glad I was able to do that. It's great. It's great. In fact, the very, very first funeral I ever did was your mom's.
Oh, is that right?
Yes, it was.
Lucille,
I can't remember that.
That was the very person I had just taken.
I didn't remember.
Yes. And
yes,
in fact,
I knew you did it.
Yes, and in fact, and somewhere in your house is this piece of paper, I'll guarantee it. But remember, your mom, really, all the times that I attended, she never made it to church because she was too elderly. But I'd go down to the house and visit with her some. Yeah. And so when she finally passed away, in fact, when she passed away, it was a Sunday morning, And I calculated it was exactly the time we were praying for during Sunday. Sending shivers up my back. So I met that afternoon with you and John, and you handed me this deposit slip from her checkbook. And on that was a list of the songs she would like to have sung, the scripture she wanted read. Yeah. On the back of that deposit slip was these words. Tom, don't make this long. Don't plan on hanging around, Lucille. I'll never forget that because I was really worried. I thought, geez, my first one. I don't want to mess it up for her, you know. And that's exactly what she said. I was completely at peace with that, you know. Okay, you set it up for me. You helped me out. You blessed me with that.
That's the way she was.
Yes, yes.
She was directing to the point.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Don't make it long. Don't plan on hanging around. So,
honey, she had worked on the railroad as a telegraph operator, and she was the first woman that ever had that job.
Oh.
It was all men.
Oh, yeah.
But she was the first woman. She had that experience. Oh, dear.
Great.
So, yeah.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Great.
Just life is not easy.
Nope, it's not.
And I tell you, it doesn't get any easier. Nah. The older you get, I guess we roll with the punches more, but...
Well, somebody told my dad, he says, when you reach 60, you get rid of all your problems. He says, what they didn't tell you was you get a whole brand new set.
Oh, yeah.
So that's one of the things that
right.
I find, so... Well, great. I'm just going to back out. You guys stay as long as you want there. Just this last year, we did, right here by the flagpole, we did the veterans.
Oh, yeah.
Veterans thing
there. I've never looked at it.
Intact Nice. I did that service for him. We wanted to do something, put the walkway in. Mm-hmm. That was interesting. I had about 15 ladies tell me how to put those bricks in there.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
You did it yourself. You did it yourself?
Well, we had a crew that helped us. And
were you supervising her?
No, I said he was well supervised.
And I was well. And one would say, well, this one, that brick's too far up. That brick's too far down. And I says, so I finally looked up at him and I says, until you get down on your knees and place three bricks, you can't talk.
Oh.
That shut them all up. They didn't all want to get down there. But it was great. We had it was a great service for the dedication of that.
Yes.
Had a military rights team out and did it. Had lots of dignitaries came. So it was really nice. They have really done a lot of work trying to keep. You know, this is just basically a country cemetery. It's hard to, you know, they've got...
I don't think I've ever been to a cemetery where there's something like that.
Nope.
For the
only one, no. Not especially not something like this size, so... Well, I'll let you guys go, and so...
Okay. Thank you very much, Tom.
Thank you. Nice meeting you there. You guys have a safe trip back when you get back there, and so... We'll see you. Mark, try
as many of you may or may not know, my mother passed away in January, and this is actually the first time that I've had a chance to come and visit her. So I thought I'd go ahead and do this song, which is one of her favorites, and she was always a big supporter of my musical career, as it were. So I thought she'd like it. There's a sweet spirit in this place, and I know that it's the spirit of the that is presence of the Lord. Sweet Holy Spirit, sweet Heavenly Dove, stay right here with us, filling us with your love. And all these blessings we lift our hearts in praise. Without a doubt, we'll know that we have been revived when we shall leave this place.